Hey guys, what's going on? In this video, I'm going to show you how to customize your date picker. I recently did a video on how to actually make a date picker show up in your app. Right now, just this code over here is pretty much making this date picker right here show up. So as you can see, it's pretty simple, but if you want to check it out, just click on the video on the top right now. But moving on to this video, we want to change the colors over here. And these colors, blue and white, they're not the default colors for the date picker. The default colors for the date picker come directly from your theme. So right now we're just using, let me show you right here on the main.dart. As you can see, the theme data is pretty much just the basic one. I just changed the primary color. That's it. Other than that, it's just the default thing. So that's why these are the colors being used by the date picker. And now what I'm going to show you is how to pick colors beyond the theme of the app. So if you want to customize it with your own colors without having to resort to changing your app's theme, this is pretty much how you do it. All you need to do is come over here and take advantage of a little property called Builder. And you know, it's just part of the show date picker function right here. And in the Builder, if I do Control Q, you can see that not only does it expect an anonymous function, but it also needs these arguments right here, the build context and the widget. So let's just go ahead and, you know, give it the context and the widget. I'm going to call it child because that's pretty much what it is. And here you probably already know we could do this and then do the return keyword, but I'm just going to do the arrow pointing forward to return. The point is you have to return something in this function. And what we're going to return is the theme. So literally just a theme class. And if we hover over this, it tells you that the parameter child is required as well as the parameter data. So let's start with the child just so that it's simpler, I hope. So basically the child, all you gotta do is literally grab this child and put it here. And I'll show you what happens if you do something different in just a little bit. But now let's go to the data because that's what really matters. What we're gonna do here is pretty much just grab something called theme data. And because I don't want to specify every single little detail about the theme data, I'm going to go ahead and use the copy with method, because this way the default values are already all filled out and I can only specify what I actually want to change. Now here, what we actually want to change is the property called color scheme. And let me just show you something. If you do color scheme like this, as you can see, there's different enums right here, but let's just say we go for the none with the enums and look at what happens. You pretty much have to specify like all of this, okay? And unless you want to be this specific, I wouldn't do this. I would actually just go ahead and do, for example, the dot dark one. I like this one, so, but you can try the other ones, but this is probably going to be the one you're going to be using the most, to be honest with you. Now here, well, obviously if I do control space, then you get all the properties we just saw, but the ones I want you to focus on, and you know, feel free to play around with all of them, you know, just to see what each of them do. But the ones I'm going to focus on right here are pretty much going to be, first it's the primary, and let me just go ahead and do colors.purple. This is going to look really ugly by the end. I just want to show you the different things that each property actually does. Now if I hit the save button, nothing will change. You have to click out of it and click again for it to show an actual update. And right now, you know, it looks pretty weird, but that's because we still need to specify some different properties, and you'll see in just a second. For now, let's focus on the purple. As you can see, the purple is pretty much the actual color of the selected day plus the color of the circle and the actual number of the current day. And also the letters of action buttons to either cancel or confirm. That's pretty much what the primary thing actually does. And then we can go to the on primary and let's give it a pink color. Why not? And hit the save button. Once again, I'm going to close this. And by the way, I don't know if you noticed, this right here is black because we changed it to dark theme. Okay, so by default, this color went black, but I will change it. Don't worry about it. And in this case, you're probably wondering where the hell is pink. But if I click away, maybe you notice it like this. As you can see, like the actual number inside the option that you're selecting is pink. So that's what we changed here. Not much, but you know, I'm giving you what you need to make your colors your own. Now the next thing is the surface. Let's give this one a very different color. Let's do deep orange, because I want you to really be able to tell the differences. Hit the save button again, click out of it, click again, and right there is where I was talking about. It was black before, but now it's orange. And then we come over here and do on surface, and let's do colors that I'm gonna do lime accent, why not? And hit the save button, click away again, open it again, and as you can see, we changed the colors of the letters and also this one right here, but we can't even see it because of the white background. So let's go ahead and just change the background color of this, because we can't really see anything right now. And you know, clearly white isn't working for us. And the way that we do that is by coming over here outside of the color scheme. So this is where we are, don't get lost. We're within the copy width. We're at the same level of the color scheme property. And we do dialogue background theme. And this time let's pick like a dark color, something like indigo, why not? And I hope your eyes are okay after seeing this, but let's just go for it. I'm gonna click away, click it back, and there you go. Okay, I guess it doesn't look that ugly. And this was what was yellow. I think you can tell that it is yellow. So this right here, as well as, you know, all the letters that are yellow, are pretty much what is in lime accent. I guess it's not really yellow, but you know what I mean. Lime accent is pretty close to yellow. I just suck at differentiating colors, so forgive me for that. But as you can see, you know, we literally took this and made it our own. And you know, what I just did was just I just played around with it. And you can do it too. As you can see, like, you have a few other options that you can check out and play around with. I'm not going to go through all of them because that's kind of pointless, seeing as that you can do that yourself. But hopefully this will get you curious enough to start it out. And before I wrap this up, let me just show you what happens if, instead of using this child on the builder, let's say you use some other widget like a text field saying hello. And let me just show you real quick what happens. I'm going to hit the save button, click away, click back, and this is what happens. So basically, this child will open whatever you give it. That's why we use this argument right here, because obviously the show date picker will bring within it, the child argument, the actual date picker. And so that's pretty much what you gotta do here. Just child property, you give it whatever you wrote here, which is the widget child. And just other than that, feel free to do whatever you want. Have fun. Try it out. And don't confuse it with this. This is just the child of the elevated button, okay? So just try this out. Don't ask me for a GitHub for this, because you have the code right here. It's super simple. Just copy it yourself. That's how you learn. You don't really learn from copy pasting. You learn from actually writing the code yourself. So please don't be mad that sometimes I don't add a GitHub repo link, because sometimes it's just, it shouldn't be there. You know what I mean? You should just do the work yourself. Otherwise, I'm not really teaching anybody how to do anything. So, you know, this is pretty much what's up. I hope this was able to help you out somehow. If it was, please hit that like button. And if you are a beginner trying to learn more and more about Flutter, also hit that subscribe button. The worst thing that'll happen to you is seeing notifications for videos teaching Flutter. I promise you that. Anyway, that's about it for today. Thank you so much for watching this video. This is Flutter Mentor, and out.